Welcome to video lecture series in Sociology. Today, we are going to discuss chapter 7 titled as Mass Media and Communications from your textbook Social Change and Development in India. As you know, we have broadly divided this chapter into four parts. So far, we have discussed about the concept and features of mass media. We have differentiated between traditional and modern means of mass communication. We have discussed about the emergence of media, its functions, both positive and negative, and the impact of mass media on society. Today in this lecture, we will discuss about the beginning of modern mass media in India under the colonial rule, that is the British rule. India has a long and rich history in which knowledge and information was passed on to generations or was shared with others through oral and written traditions. The mass media of modern type emerged during the British rule, particularly from the middle of the 19th century. And it was during the early 20th century when printing and publishing gained popularity in India. The Indian National Press played a crucial role in India's struggle for freedom. The press during the freedom struggle was used as a medium to raise voice against the oppressive measures of the British government. No doubt it can be considered as the backbone of the struggle for independence from the British colonial rule. Since the Indians had no social or political rights under the British rule, there was no question of freedom of expression through media or any other way. The importance and significance of press and mass media lies in its role, particularly in mobilizing the masses out of the long slumber. The history of Indian journalism shows that a number of laws and regulations for media were enacted mainly to cater to the interest of the British during their rule, and suppress any move that could have led to the rise of anti-British sentiment among the people. The nationalist movement emerged in the wake of institutional changes brought about by the British rule in India, as we have already discussed in the previous chapters. Resistance against the British rule and anti-colonial public sentiment was propagated and channelized through press and other means of mass communication, which we will discuss now. The important role of press and media in the struggle for freedom can be established by looking at the awareness it generated among people. It led to creation of public opinion that led to emergence of class consciousness among people. Let us discuss about the history of mass media in India briefly. The modern Indian press was established after the advent of Europeans, that is, the British as the colonial power in India since 16th century onwards. The first press in India was established by the Portuguese in 1550. The first weekly newspaper in India was called as Bengal Gazette. It was started by James Augustus Hickey in 1780. Madras Courier Weekly was started in 1785. In 1790, Bombay Courier, and in 1791, Bombay Gazette merged with Bombay Herald in 1792. In 1818, Marshman from Srirampur started the first Bengali weekly called as Digdarshan. Some other major newspapers of this time are the Shom Prakash in Bengali. It was started by Ishwarchand Vidyasagar in 1858. Another important publication was by Fardunji Murzban. He was the pioneer of Gujarati press in Bombay. He started Bombay Samachar Daily in 1822. The Times of India was founded in Bombay in 1861, the Pioneer in Allahabad in 1865. Another important newspaper of that time was Madras Mail, which was started in 1868. The Statesman started in 1875 from Kolkata. And finally, the Civil and Military Gazette started in Lahore in 1876. Though the establishment of press can be seen as one of the institutional changes introduced by the British, but it did not take long for Indians to realize the immense potential of mass media as a vehicle to spread ideas and communicate with large number of people. It was in fact due to the courage of the social reformers, nationalist freedom fighters, that despite being under pressure, control and censorship of the colonial government, press continued to flourish in India. The growth of mass media, particularly newspaper and magazines, can be attributed to the efforts of those individuals who used media as a means of communication to sensitize masses on a variety of social, economic, political issues and about anti-colonial ideas without fearing the British Raj. The newspapers and magazines spread general awareness among masses regarding the slavery. The content of these papers and magazines was quite diverse, in fact. Apart from reporting the general events happening in India and abroad, there were many items or features on ideas pertaining to modernity, about education, secular education, and challenges to tradition, superstition, and orthodoxy. Social reformers used these channels of communication to spread ideas regarding social reform and public welfare, discussing various social evils and issues. Some of the relevant issues plaguing Indian society were severely condemned through media. The social reformers criticized the traditional practice that were holding development of people back. They propagated modern, rational, scientific and secular ideas enthusiastically and discussed issues like relevance of modern education, abolishing social evils like child marriage, sati, caste inequality or discrimination. One of the leading social reformers of early 19th century, Raja Ram Mohan Roy, started Sambad Kaumudi in Bengali in 1821 and Mirat-ul-Akbar in Persian in 1822. Although there were newspapers started by others earlier than these papers, but the papers started by Raja Ram Mohan Roy were the first publications in India with a distinct nationalistic and democratic approach. The press was soon established in almost all the regions of India. Newspapers and magazines were published in local and regional languages also, as they could be read by people in other local regional languages and dialects. The social reformers and Western educated elite had a firm belief in the capacity of mass media to shape public opinion. Along with planning for the freedom of nation, these leaders devoted most of their time writing about various social issues. They used press to disseminate ideas regarding freedom, liberty, equality, and social justice. They wrote extensively for safeguarding the social and political rights and civil liberties of citizens of modern India. Gradually, in the beginning of 20th century, the press became the most powerful instrument for the nationalist and social reformers to communicate to masses. Under the able leadership of people like Gandhiji, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Gopal Krishna Gokhale. As a reaction, the colonial government imposed censorship on the media. Throughout the freedom struggle, Mahatma Gandhi wrote a lot about Swaraj. He wrote against caste system, social inequalities, and orthodox practices plaguing Indian society. One of the most popular works of Gandhiji is Hind Swaraj, published first in Gujarati in 1909. Hind Swaraj is also seen as a dream Gandhiji had woven regarding India's freedom movement and the nature of independent India. It was later translated into English and other languages as well. Gandhiji was also editor of a couple of newspapers including Harijan in Gujarati and Young India in English. Pandit Nehru also wrote extensively during these years. The Discovery of India and Glimpses of Modern History are well-known works written by him. The Discovery of India is a seminal work which Pandit Nehru wrote during his imprisonment in Ahmednagar Fort in Maharashtra during 1942-46. In The Discovery of India, Nehru argued that India was a historic nation with a right to sovereignty. He discussed about philosophy of Indian civilization and life in great detail in this work. Print media during the early 20th century had become a strong medium to convey social messages to masses. An important name in the field of Hindi literature is of Munshi Premchand. Premchand wrote a large number of novels, stories, essays and translated many foreign works. In 1923, he established a press and publishing house in Banaras called as Saraswati Press. Premchand's writing focused on the problems of the poor and middle class, both in rural and urban areas. In fact, his writings exhibit a rational approach to life. He was critical of hypocrisy, and he perceived religion as a tool that is being used by the powerful to exploit the weak. Through his writings, Munshi Premchand attempted to generate social awareness among people about national and social issues. He wrote mainly about poverty, changing value systems, exploitation of poor in feudal system, child widowhood, colonialism, and India's freedom movement as well. A large number of works of prominent nationalists, social reformers, writers and poets were published during these years. Some of the important names are Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Rabindranath Tagore, Sarojini Naidu, Subramanyam Bharti, Muhammad Iqbal, Maithili Sharan Gupta, Ramdhari Singh Dinkar and many others who motivated masses through their writings. In totality, all these works were exemplary in fostering the spirit of nationalism, sacrifice, duty towards the motherland, devotion and struggle. The colonial state attempted to silence the anti-colonial voice raised by the nationalist newspapers by imposing ban on them, on printing and circulation as well, like Kesari in Marathi, Matrubhumi in Malayalam, Amrit Bazar Patrika in English. But even these bans could not prevent them from advocating the cause of nationalism, demanding Swaraj and raising voice to end colonial rule. These newspapers played an important role in mobilizing masses during India's struggle for independence. In fact, apart from newspapers, a variety of types of mass media emerged in India under the British rule. These were magazines, films and radio. The radio broadcast was owned by and controlled by the state totally. As a result, it was fully censored, and any anti-colonial or nationalistic view was not aired on it. Although newspapers and films were supposed to be autonomous, but their content also was strictly monitored by the Raj, so that they could not be used to spread anti-British content and ideas. But newspapers and magazines in English had limited readership because only a small percentage knew English at that point of time. The papers in vernacular language were also not widely circulated, again, because there were few who could read or write or who were literates. However, despite having limited circulation, the impact of these writings was huge. The news and information contained in these papers was spread orally among people during public gatherings, local meetings like marketplaces, weekly hearts, trading centers and town halls. The strong belief and philosophy of social reformers and political leaders of that time that pen is mightier than sword, it can challenge any power, still guides the spirit of modern journalism in India. Despite criticism of the manner in which modern media functions, press and journalism is considered to be the true voice or representation of the people in India. It is seen as a means to contribute to the healthy functioning of Indian democracy. Media, in fact, in India has a strong support from government and the civil society for being a vital source of communication between the state and the society. It is largely true that the strength of the press in independent India is derived from the role media played in the advocacy of social reforms and emancipation in supporting the political struggle of the nationalists who used media as a channel for communication with masses during the freedom struggle. In fact, the success of these endeavors offered great legitimacy to the position, role and strength of media in society. Media in independent India is characterized by autonomy, independent functioning, commitment to offer platform for free speech and expression of ideas, resistant to state oppression and censorship, and protector of fundamental rights of the people. Many modern dailies or newspapers portray their roles as enlighters, leaders and innovators. So, one can say that media is a strong force that can generate awareness among masses. Media in a democracy provides platform for debate on alternative and contending perspectives that are important for functioning of society. It shapes people's perception and opinion that can push political parties and policy makers to address fundamental issues related to growth and development of people. To conclude, let's summarize what we discussed in this lecture. We started our discussion with the emergence of modern mass media in India and emergence of media under the British colonial times. We also discussed about the role of print media, the press in generating awareness among people and how it helped in the rise of spirit of nationalism. We briefly discussed about the writings of social reformers, nationalists and the political leaders in generating awareness among the masses and how they used media as a channel for communication. In the next part of this lecture series, we'll talk about the emerging trends in the field of mass media in India and its impact upon people. Till then, you can enjoy reading this part of the chapter. Thank you.